Hi friends, this video is for reinforcement learning. This is also one of the learning strategies or one of the learning paradigms. So let us see what exactly the reinforcement learning. This comes under the learning paradigm of learning without a teacher. Here there is no teacher, as we have discussed in the previous supervised learning. So the learning of an input and output mapping is performed through continued interaction with the environment in order to minimize the scalar index of the performance. So in this thing, we need to continuously, for each and every iteration, we need to have communication with the environment. That means it's a closed loop in which the environment is also a part, just opposite to supervised learning. In supervised learning, it's also a closed loop, but environment is not the part and it is outside the closed loop, but here it is inside the closed loop. That's only the difference. Let us see how it will work. This is the block diagram. Environment is there, and the environment is given to critic and also learning system. Here in place of teacher, critic will be there. This is the state variable, or the input state variable, has been given from environment to critic and also learning system. And then primary reinforcement is given from environment to the critic, so that it will convert the primary reinforcement into heuristic reinforcement, and this is high quality reinforcement, so that some change will be happened in learning system, and that change is brought back to the environment. This is the basic idea here. So environment is connected to critic and learning system, and critic is getting some extra information, primary reinforcement. Based on that, critic will analyze these things and it will provide the learning system such that there is a heuristic reinforcement, and that heuristic reinforcement has been trained, that input is sufficient to train the learning system in some way, and that output is given to the environment again to change the environment. And once that has been changed, then the primary reinforcement is changed, heuristic reinforcement is changed. So all these things will be changed in the next iteration. That means for each and every iteration, we need to touch with the environment definitely. That means it's a closed loop in which environment is one of the parts, unlike the supervised learning. So these are the actions. Actions are given to environment. So figure shows the system is built around the critic that convert the primary reinforcement into heuristic reinforcement signal that we have already discussed. The primary reinforcement is from environment. The heuristic, it's of high quality. Okay. So the goal of learning is to minimize the cost to go function, defined as the expectation of cumulative cost of actions taken over a sequence of steps instead of simply the intermediate cost. Here we, instead of taking intermediate cost, here we are taking the cumulative cost. That means step by step cost we need to take. So all these step by step cost has been functioned as cost to go function, and that function has to be minimized. And coming to delayed reinforcement learning, so this is called delayed reinforcement learning because the information has to pass to critic, and then it will take some time to provide the heuristic reinforcement. So this is the delayed one. In this, there are some disadvantages. There is no teacher to provide the desired response at each step of the learning process. So the delay, so this is the one of the disadvantages. There is no teacher. If teacher is there, he will say what is right and what is wrong, or he will provide the desired response for each and every step. That means for each and every iteration. But here there is no teacher, so that is lacking in this system. Coming to the delayed incurred, the delay incurred in the generation of primary reinforcement signal implies that The learning machine must solve a temporal credit assignment problem. Here, what exactly happening is the temporary credit assignment problem has to be executed. That means for each and every action, it has to give the credit or blame. And then the delay will be incurred. So the delay incurred in the generation of the primary reinforcement signal implies that the learning machine must solve a temporal credit assignment problem. Why the delay is coming means it has to solve the temporal credit assignment problem so that the delay has been incurred or delay has been occurred in this primary reinforcement signal. So coming to this, the credit or blame to each action in sequence of time steps that led to the final outcome, while the primary reinforcement may only evaluate the outcome. This has been nicely explained in credit assignment problem video, where what is the credit assignment problem? So the temporal credit assignment problem has been utilized in this case. So for each and every action, we need to provide credit or blame, and then only we need to go ahead. Just like so in previously also we have discussed, it is instead of taking the intermediate cost, it needs to take the cumulative cost. So to take the cumulative cost, we need to solve this problem only, temporal credit assignment problem. So we need to give credit or blame to the each and every action. For that one only we are taking some time, that's why delay incurred in this generation of primary reinforcement signal. So these are the disadvantages in delayed reinforcement learning. But there are very good advantages. The advantages are, it is very good appealing. That means it provides the basis for the system to interact with the environment. It always interacting with the environment. So definitely it's very appealing system. That means it's very close to the environment. Thereby developing the ability to learn a performance in a prescribed task solely on the basis of the outcomes of its experience that result from the interaction. So it's solely based on the task, based on the outcomes of the experience. So once it has been experienced, it's solely based on those outcomes only. Next, it's closely related to the dynamic programming. It's almost equal to the dynamic programming only. That means suppose suddenly if our environment has been changed, everything will be set up according to the environment, so that we can have a chance to change the environment completely also. So that's why it's very close to the dynamic programming. These are some of the advantages of delayed reinforcement learning. With this is complete explanation of reinforcement learning. And thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video to your friends, please try to share this video to your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed so far, please kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel and try to press on the bell button so that you will get the notification whenever I upload a new video. Thank you. Thank you so much.